Why are we here and what are we doing? Today's work is looking at the Common Core, and many of you are probably somewhat too very familiar with Common Core. We're looking at especially some of the communication skills, but the piece that we're very much looking at is how do we infiltrate those Common Core topics and skills within other lessons that you're doing. And my personal view is that most all of you are retained classroom elementary people. You've got the best world that we can possibly do. And on top of that, you've got administrator people here with you as well who are hearing this. So instead of a model, and you've done this at some point in your life, from 9:08 to 10:14, we do X, whatever that thing is. Okay, that's dedicated reading time, or that's dedicated math time, or whatever. Think about how you can blend something within the framework of an environmental lesson or a science topic lesson. Use all of those skills and do all of those things you're supposed to be doing in Common Core, in your language arts, and in your mathematics. Look at a lesson and say, I've got opportunities. Am I tapping into those and doing everything I could be and should be with my kids? So using the framework of the science, and those of you who are in the magnet schools that have some of those magnet grants, that say, I've got to step up my science teaching from 3 hours this year to 6 hours next year to, my God, 12 hours, how am I going to do that? I've still got these blocks of time. You can successfully integrate the whole shield. Take some work, but I think what you're going to find when you do that is that it's much more meaningful for your kids. They get the conversation that you're going through. They've got a good reason to be doing the math, and they see why you need that tool. They understand that I can find cool stuff in a nonfiction reader that supports me in the what I needed to know about, I don't know, bugs, plants, tarantulas, I don't know what we're looking at today, from, you know, whatever your lesson is. But I can look and use that and do that. And I need to know if my, this is so not going to happen in classroom, my tarantula is faster than your tarantula because we set up tarantula races. That's not happening. But how would I know it was faster? I need mathematics to know that it was faster. How much faster was my tarantula than yours? I can see this happening, can't you? That's math. What do we have to do? We have tortoises in some classes, so probably not tarantulas. How do I know? And it's a mathematics question. So, and every kid wants to be faster than the other kid, so how will you know you got there? That's math. So how do you do that? I mean, this is what we're talking about, integrating all the parts and pieces. So that's what we're going for. And you've got your administrators here, and they're hearing the same thing too. So hopefully this is the permission to say, show me how you can put it all in one bag, and hey, we're good. That's our hope. Okay, except that you've got the best of the best of the best administrators here. It's those others that I was learning about. Questions on goals and what we're looking for?